Trump administration officials say they're pushing for a diplomatic solution to the North Korea crisis, even as the Pentagon examines all its military options. Secretary of Defense James Mattis and Secretary of State Rex Tillerson wrote an opinion piece in this morning's Wall Street Journal. They say the U.S. is not interested in regime change in North Korea. They also say Washington is willing to negotiate with Pyongyang if the regime ends its provocative threats, nuclear tests, and missile launches. Ben Tracy is in Beijing with new reaction from North Korea. Ben?
Good morning. So the North Korean government had been noticeably quiet for several days, but this morning issued a new threat through its state media. And part of that threat says, despite our warning, if the U.S. continues to wield a nuclear bat in front of a nuclear power, it will only accelerate its own self-destruction. Now, earlier today, the U.S. and Japan conducted large-scale joint military exercises on Japan's northernmost island. And over the weekend, Japan installed 4 missile interceptor systems, which could be used to shoot down North Korean missiles that fly over Japan. Meanwhile, the chairman of the U.S. Joint Chiefs of Staff met with South Korea's president today in Seoul. Marine General Joseph Dunford said the United States is ready to use what he called the full range of its military capabilities to defend itself and its allies from North Korea. Dunford is now heading here to Beijing, where he will meet with China's military leaders. Meanwhile, the Chinese government is warning the Trump administration once again not to link U.S.-China trade issues with North Korea. And they are doing that because President Trump is expected today to launch an investigation into whether or not China stole intellectual property and trade secrets from the U.S. Charlie?
Thank you. Ben Tracy in Beijing.